So what is going on, guys? I'm sure you are doing well, and in this episode let's see the difference between map method and they almost do same thing but they have major difference. So what the difference is, again as usual, I have this user's data or the collection we have, and refresh, yeah, we have some collections where we have is admin 1, email confirm 1, and here you can see is admin 1, email confirm is 0. So again, lots of data and we need to play with this. So let's say I'm having each function. What each function will do, again, it will iterate through each and every item of the collection and you can perform certain things. This can be very useful when you have to send an email to lots of users, so you get the collection of the users, then you can use each and you can just perform anything you want. So behind the scene, actually each is using for each loop, which is here, for each loop, which we know is similar, each for each. So it's like you can have a user and you can just say send email like that. So it will be very useful in that case. So if I am not doing anything here, so if I go and refresh, yes, I'm getting all the result because I have just not done anything, but each method will return everything. If I use map here instead of this, you can see we are not getting anything, null, 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 because from this function, from this callback function, we need to perform something, we need to return something. So let's say I am going to return everything and I'm not doing anything with this user data I have. So it's just performing everything and returning each and everything. But the real power of map function is that you can modify things and then you can return. So suppose I'm just going to return name. So now this map function will create another collection which just having the name in it and nothing else. So if I now go and refresh, you can see we just have the collection or simple array of the name only. So if I say I want name, so it will be like here. So name as this, and then I want ID also. So ID is user arrow ID. So let's just give here, refresh, and we only have two things in our collection. So you can see map is very powerful. You can also do one thing. Suppose you just want to have, let's just return firstly the users so that we can see what we have. And here the fourth one you can see is admin is 1 and email is not confirmed. I just want to have a simple system that if the person is an admin, then he don't need to confirm his email. So it's like we just have to check if user is admin is equal to 1, then we need to say user arrow email confirmed is equal to 1, and then after that we are returning the user. So if the value of is admin is 1, then making email confirmed, and if this is not the case, then return as it is. So what we are expecting, that fourth ID has email to be confirmed. So refresh, and yes, you can see email confirmed is now 1 here. So this is very useful with the case of map method. You can also do some of the cool stuffs. So suppose you don't want to have created and updated, you just want name, email, and is admin. So here we will go and we will say only, we need to get only, and here we name, then email, let's just see only these two. So if I go and refresh this page, yes, we only have email and name by using this map method. So you can see map method is very, very powerful. But if I use each method, what will be the result? Let's see. It's not going to work because each method will give all the data it have, because each method is for performing something related to each and every user. That's why it is named as each. One thing more you can do with this each is that sometime you want to stop the iteration. So suppose this condition is here, and I will say if admin is 0, then I just want to return false. So I'm not going to return anything here. And if this is not the case, I'm just going to print whatever is the user arrow ID. And let's just use one more echo with br tag to give a new line. Okay, so let's go and see the result. And before that, let me show you this thing that if I not have any return false, then I will refresh and I get 51, because every item has some ID, which is 51 IDs. But if I have this, and as soon as it get is admin 0, it stop the iteration. So let's go to Chrome, refresh the page, and only one we have. Maybe I think what it's saying that we are getting is admin 0 at the second position. So return everything, and yes, you can see is admin is 0. So let me give you another example. If I say ID is let's say 14, then return false, otherwise print these things. So we are expecting to have only 14 items here. So return, and you can see here as soon as it get the 14th value, it return the false and stop the iteration. And this is very useful if you want some kind of stopping system for this each loop. So this is the major difference between map and each is just used for performing something over the each iteration, and map is to get something performed on each iteration and returning the new array with the modified data. So this is all about these things. And if you have not subscribed to this channel, go and subscribe to this channel and hit the bell icon to get instant notification, because here Laravel knowledge never ends. And like Bitfumes on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, LinkedIn, wherever you want, and we will meet in the next episode. Till then, goodbye.